Hello, everybody, and welcome back. I am super excited to share today's video as I have been working on it for over a month. If you do follow me on Instagram, you will know that I have been doing Beachbody's Piyo program for the past 4 weeks. It has had some ups and downs, and we will absolutely talk through that. But if you are not familiar, Beachbody does have several different programs, and the one that I chose to do this time was Piyo. It's a mix of Pilates and yoga, so you're really keeping the movement going to get your heart rate up a little bit, but you're also building flexibility, toning, and strengthening your body. The workouts range anywhere from 20 to 40 minutes per day, and you work out 6 days a week. They do provide you with a calendar or a schedule to follow if you prefer, and that is exactly what I did. Now, they do also recommend that you follow their diet. However, as I've been doing all along, I did continue to go with keto as well as doing intermittent fasting for the morning. Also, the only equipment that you do need for this workout is a yoga mat, which I found super easy. It's something that I have, but I did want to try to find a workout where I didn't need to go out and buy dumbbells or buy different equipment, but really utilize my own body weight and strength to help maximize my workout. For me, I did find that the earlier that I completed the workout in my day, the better and more likely I was to actually getting it complete. I was super stringent. I wanted to make sure that I would complete all the workouts, so I would post daily on Instagram to hold myself accountable when I had completed the workout. I will say there were days where I didn't do it until in the afternoon or even in the evening, and it was just something that was in the back of my mind the whole day, and it became a task that I needed to do as opposed to a motivation to make me feel better throughout that day. Because when I completed the workout in the morning, I would feel amazing. I felt like I was gonna get a lot accomplished that day. It just started off my day right. Now, I have a 1.5-year-old toddler that would love to come and give me kisses and bother mommy a bit while working out, but we did make the most fun out of it, and I just did the best that I could. And that is part of the reason why sometimes my workouts did get delayed until her lunchtime, but then if I ended up eating beforehand, then I didn't feel like working out right away. So it just kind of threw me off, but this is again what worked for me personally, is getting it done first thing in the morning. Now, I did have a through different things to go through as well throughout this duration, because in my time frame, Halloween did pass by. And honestly, working out just made me feel a lot better. Now, on Halloween, I did cheat and I ate quite a bit of candy. And I have to say, the next day when I worked out, I felt like crap. I didn't feel like working out. I didn't feel flexible. I was aching, but I am so happy that I had the motivation and that accountability to continue to work out, because I really needed that to get back into the swing of stuff. Also, about a week later, I had my lovely monthly visitor come by, which I have quite a bit of cramping on the first day, and I actually did not look forward to working out. However, it felt so nice. It just felt like it shifted things in my body. I felt more flexible, and honestly, it made it a lot easier of a day than I typically have. Now, that could also be because I've been doing keto for a little bit now, so more to come on that in future videos, but it did make me feel a lot better, and it was exciting to know that there was something to help the way I felt without needing to take pills to get through that first day. So overall, while completing this program, I did feel a lot more flexible. I did feel really good about my intentions for the day, which I really think just came down to actually completing a workout. And also, every time I did complete a workout following, I never went, oh, I didn't want to do that, or that was awful. I always felt so accomplished. I never understood the saying where you'll never regret a workout until this program, because honestly, I never regret a workout. Afterwards, I always felt like I had accomplished something, and really, 20 to 40 minutes, there's no excuse to not do it. Now, I'm sitting here saying this knowing full well I made it 3 weeks and 1 day on the program, and I stopped. I know I said I was gonna do 4 weeks. That was my intentions. However, that week emotionally, it was even after my period, so I don't know why I was so emotional. However, it got to be too much for me, and I was really at a breaking point of, do I just give up on my diet, my keto journey and everything and cave in for the holidays, or do I let this workout go for now? And I needed to just let that workout go. At first, I thought I was just gonna skip that one day, but I did end up missing the rest of the program up through the final 4 weeks. So really, I completed 3 weeks and one day. I'm a little disappointed in myself, but I also know that I made the right choice for myself. I am still part of a StepFet program. If you wanna know more about that, feel free to ask in the comments, but that is where I do have to take active steps. So it's not like I am not actively participating in something. I just had too much on my plate that week and needed to let something go. And unfortunately that was Piyo. But I also think that that's a glimpse into what is real life like. We can't set these high expectations of ourselves and expect to meet them all the time and then feel like a failure when we don't meet them. I think that's part of life, is learning through these journeys and listening to our bodies and our mentality and knowing what is best for us. And at that moment, what was best for me was to let go of Piyo for now. Because I will say it is an ongoing program I definitely want to hold on to, and I do want to continue to have something that keeps me active. Now, I did take before and after pictures. Now, I didn't see much change in my actual body. However, it was also only 3 weeks and one day. And as we know, mentally, we sometimes have blocks. And so I just don't see much of a change. However, I know that I felt it on a daily basis. And if 20 minutes of working out can make me feel so much better, then it's definitely something that I should continue to do. So overall, during this process, I did lose 3.8 pounds in that 3 weeks and one day. And that was, of course, as I had stated, partnering with intermittent fasting as well as doing keto. This is definitely something that I would recommend if you are just looking to start getting active and you're not quite ready for some of those intense workouts, but just want to feel better in the movement of your body. I think this is a really good starter workout and definitely one that I will hold on to just in case I need an easy, relaxing day, but where I feel really good and accomplished, because I think the workouts give you a lot of mental space. It's not just intense HIIT workouts. They are really where you are feeling your body and feeling the movement, which is really nice sometimes. So I take full accountability for not completing the 4 weeks. It is nothing on the program. It is all about what I was going through in that moment. And I'm excited to join future programs or try out different workouts throughout this journey. I'm really good at maintaining my keto and the way that I eat. However, I am not one that loves exercise, so I really do want to switch up what programs I do at least every month or so. And so this is a really great way for me to still stay active on that journey of weight loss. I did still want to share this experience with you because yes, I did not complete the full program, but I also think we are all human and we go through some of those things. And I hope that you can take something away from this and learn from it. And know that if you didn't make it, it doesn't mean that you're a failure. You are just listening to yourself and you will get back up and do a different exercise. If you have other workout programs that you have done in the past, please feel free to recommend those in the comments below. I would love to know and try those out. If you are new here, I would love for you to subscribe and like this video, as I will have more to come and would love to share that journey with you.